Welcome back to the Astro Room, your very own portal to the cosmos. And what we're going to do in this video is we're going to compare the Celestron Nexstar 8SE telescope with the C-Star S50. Now, I know what you're thinking. This seems like an unfair comparison, but is it really? Let's check it out. Let's dig in. Now make sure you see the whole video because we're going to see side-by-side comparisons, video comparisons of Jupiter, Saturn, and the Moon. Obviously, when comparing the specifications of each scope, the differences are huge. However, you have to think primarily about what exactly are you trying to get out of the telescope. Do you want detailed view of planets and prefer to look straight through the eyepiece and you don't really care about astrophotography? Well, then get the Celestron. It can be set up for astrophotography, but the cost will add up since you will need to buy separately your camera, etc., and more things. Or wait, are you looking for portability? Something you can grab and go, travel with, lightweight, easy to use? Well, then you want the C-Star. It also includes astrophotography if you'd like that. Now, the Celestron does have other options in its Nexstar lineup that are smaller. But at the end of the day, the lightest option as far as weight is the C-Star. It's also, I would say, the most user-friendly. Not that the Celestron is necessarily difficult, but it does have its bigger learning curve, especially at the beginning. Now, both of these telescopes really are amazing scopes on their own. I actually own both, and I love both of them. And you really shouldn't compare, but what is being compared here is what you're getting for the amount of money you are spending. Is it worth spending $1,600 or $500? That's for you to decide. Like I said, it really depends on your objective as to what you expect and what you want from a telescope. Now, both of these videos were recorded with an iPhone. So with the Celestron, that is just my phone recording straight through the eyepiece. It's a raw recording. I must say for sure that in person, it looks a lot better. The details do stand out way more when you're looking straight at it with your own eyes through the eyepiece, and it does look absolutely beautiful. It's hard to really capture just how nice it looks through a phone recording. Now, don't let the small size on the C-Star, on that video to the right, make you think we can't zoom in just as well, or even better. Let's see the next video. By the way, this is Jupiter we are looking at here. It really is worth noting what you can get for the price of the C-Star. And this is coming from a little telescope that wasn't even built for planetary viewing. Not bad, right? Now, if you're wondering how on Earth I got such an extreme zoom in 100x of Jupiter, check out my other video that I made that shows more in detail this, but it's actually super easy. Now, what we're looking at here is through both telescopes. You have the Celestron on the left, once again, the C-Star on the right. We're looking at the full moon. Now, keep in mind that the worst time to see the moon through a telescope eyepiece is when it's the full moon, because the moonlight is so bright that it makes it harder to see the details of the lunar surface, such as its craters. Now, as you see the video here on the left, you're going to see that I truly am looking through an eyepiece, right? You see it slowly. That's my phone moving out, zooming out, and then going back in. But check out the C-Star right there on the right. This is a raw video. There are no edits to this. Look at those natural, beautiful, gorgeous colors coming out of this. Keeping in mind that the C-Star does have a built-in camera, a sensor image. It's built for astrophotography. It's built exactly for this, so you can see these beautiful colors coming out, these details of a full moon and of other objects. But let's look at the Celestron. Look at what this does. The C-Star cannot do this. I'm looking directly through an eyepiece, and I'm able to see up close, extremely close, with my own eyes, lunar craters, the surface of the moon, in such fine, truly just really, really nice details. Okay, but wait, what about the C-Star? Can we zoom in? Of course we can. Look at this. Now, The recording on the left, if it looks a little not fully clear to you, it's because I'm actually screen recording this. The reason why I'm screen recording from my phone is because I'm trying to be able to show that it is possible to zoom in while you're viewing it, while you're recording it. That's the only reason why it's like that. But take a look at the right here, the clouds passing through. It's just absolutely beautiful. Once again, these are raw videos. There's no editing, no enhancing, no stacking of images, nothing like that. As a matter of fact, there's none of that in any of this that I'm showing you. By the way, I do have a couple other videos of the moon through the sea star. Feel free to check those out too. Now, I've left this for last. This is on the Celestron 8SE. This is something that the sea star yet cannot do. Remember, that telescope was not built for planetary viewing, but I mean, it's come pretty far. However, what we see here in the Celestron is Saturn. Look at this. This is beautiful. This is straight through the eyepiece, no stacking of images, nothing like that, no stacking of this video. This is raw. Now, even in person, I must say it's way better. There's nothing like looking through the eyepiece and being able to see this. When you try to look at Saturn through the sea star, though, I didn't even decide to put in any video or any image because it honestly just doesn't compare. It's just not the best, right? But here, Saturn just looks amazing through the Celestron Nexstar 8SE. So let's look at the specifications. Here it is, plain and simple. I have both of them next to each other. Now, really, at the end of the day, I'm just going to go ahead and say, I love both of these telescopes. And hey, both of them do two completely different things. So really up to you. Why not get both? But I mean, like I said, if you want to grab and go, lightweight, portable, why not the sea star? But if you're looking for planetary viewing, details at looking at Jupiter, details at looking at Saturn and its rings, straight with your own eyes, then hey, the Celestron is incredible. And remember those lunar pictures that we saw, or that lunar video, the craters? Nothing beats being able to change magnifications with an eyepiece, doing everything like that on your own, and just seeing it straight with your eye. It really is amazing. So it's up to you. Which one do you think? The Celestron? The sea star? Keep in mind, the SeaStar was built specifically for astrophotography. Thanks for watching!